Today we're going to be making our own washi tape using a jelly plate and some masking tape. We're going to print using paints to create our coloured background, and then we're going to add some extra detail using stamps when we're finished as well. So to begin with, I've got some pieces of tracing paper. You could use a bit of deli paper or some acetate, and just going to be putting pieces of masking tape across this so that we can print onto it using our jelly plate. So cover your piece of paper with strips of masking tape like this, and we can then print a whole sheet at a time, which hopefully should turn out all right. I've chosen some colours of DecoArt media paints and some nice bright ones here. We've got primary magenta, primary yellow, pearl orange, cobalt teal hue, and green gold. And I'm going to be using a mixture of those on my plate. I'm using the 5x7 inch plate today. I do have a larger one, could easily do a larger one, but I find this is quite a quick and easy one to work with. So I'm going to begin by putting some bits of paint onto my plate, work with two or three colours at a time. You don't want to put too much paint on. If you get too much, it tends to just smear everywhere. That might be enough. And then using a brayer, I've got a couple of sizes to choose from here. Quite like the small one. Just going to spread this paint out evenly. Once we've got pretty good coverage, we can do a print. Always take a bit of excess paint off there. I'm going to take my first piece, just move those others out of the way. And place it down and press on. You can use a brayer if you want to do this, just to get an even coverage. And there you can see we've got a base coat on there. I'm going to add, rather than clean this off, I just go in with a bit more colour. So I'm going to add a bit of orange on there, and maybe a bit more of the teal on the other side. Roll off the excess on your scrap. This is a piece of deli paper I've got down in my background. Take my second sheet, press that down, see what we've got there. So again, this is just the base coat, and it doesn't take too long to dry either. Move that one out of the way. Let's go in with a bit of magenta, some more blue, quite like that blue, a bit of orange down there. looking for a fairly thin, even coverage. Try not to blend the colours too much. I like to see the different colours in there. Take the sheet, press it down. And there we have another print. So the next thing we can think about doing is adding some extra texture with one of the stencils or some foam stamps. So I'm just going to take off the excess bit of this paint here, I think, onto a scrap of paper. I'm not bothered if it's not completely clean. I just don't want it to have too much paint on there because I want to go in with a completely different colour this time. So the first print we did was mostly yellow and green. So as a contrast to that, I think I'm going to put the magenta and the orange on here. And then I'm going to take a stencil. This one. This is one of the stencils from Joggles, one of their 6x9 inch stencils, and I'm going to put it down over there. I'm going to take my first print and put that face down over the top of that and use my brayer to roll over it carefully, stopping it from moving about too much if possible. And that's transferred a pattern onto there, which is really nice. We don't really want to waste this too much, so if we've got a stash of paper, we can take some prints. I'll just grab some of that. So this is just some white cardstock that I've got. And I'll use this for the backgrounds of cards, ATCs, postcards, bookmarks. It'll come in handy for something. There's a nice texture in there. We're getting the stripes from where the pieces of tape were, but we've got the pattern from that stencil. Right, we're going to go in with some more paint. This time I think I'm going to use a bit of the green gold. I'm not too bothered about cleaning this off now. There's only a faint amount of paint left on it. And we'll go in with the teal as well. Left on there, we'll add an extra layer in. on the print, and we should actually see a little bit of that transferring through if we're lucky. So this time I'm going to use this stencil, another joggle stencil. I like the fact they're just a little bit bigger than the jelly plate, makes them easy to put on there. And we're going to put our next sheet down. And just brayer through the stencil to add an extra layer of pattern. That's really cute, that one. Very nice little triangle design. And again, don't waste what's left on there. Let's just take a print off that. And there you can see the remnants of that first design. Very nice texture on that one. For our last one, instead of using a stencil to add some extra pattern, I'm going to use the foam stamps that I've pulled out here. So using a little bit of the yellow paint and the teal paint, just spray that over the jelly plate. These little foam stamps, I think, are Claudine Halmoth Studios. I quite like using the foam stamps. So we're just going to use those to remove some of the paint, add in texture. Now you could stamp this off onto a piece of card. I'm just stamping it onto my scrap piece here. This was our final print that we did. Put that down. And you should be able to just faintly see the circles. Not as obvious is the first two with the stencil. And we'll just do a secondary print onto a piece of card to use that up. And again, just brings out a little bit of that pattern there. So we're going to just let that dry for a little while. Because then we're going to come back and do some stamping detail onto it. So I'm just going to clear this out of the way. Right, I've cleaned up all that mess and I've got out a selection of stamps and some archival ink. I wasn't very happy with the print that I did with the foam stamp. The yellow paint I used in the second layer was a bit pale, so I put some magenta back on the jelly plate and did it with that, which was darker than the background, and it showed up the circles a lot better. So I was a bit happier with that. So what we're going to do now is do some stamping. Now we can use border stamps, little individual stamps, text stamps. I've just grabbed a selection and I'm going to see what we can do with what we've got here. Obviously a good starting point is some border stamps, because these are strips. These are set up to border lines. Quite like these. Quite a good chunky design. So let's take that for example. And all we need to do is ink up our stamp. Stamp onto our tape. I'm just going to do a couple with this design. One of the set actor sets I've got is this context. And I quite like this stamp that says what will happen in the story next. Repeated. Stamp that onto one of these. Down on this bottom one as well. You don't have to use border stamps. This set here, Destination Unknown, Invisible Image. Has some cool little paper aeroplanes and paper boats and some good words. So we could create our own design for individual stamps. Boat, and then we could stamp one of the words next to it. Use the words on one of these. Stick a couple of words. Let's stamp that word. another one of the visible image sets that I've pulled out here is the Somewhere in Time set. There's a nice large stamp with cogs on it. Quite a large stamp, so I'm going to go across two rows of tape with that. It's not the best impression. Let's have a better look at this end. It's a little bit better. Another set that I've pulled out here from Paper Artsy, one of the Anna Nazinski art ones. I quite like this little border of flowers at the bottom. Just add a little bit more to that end. So that's worked really nicely on there. Let's see if that comes out on this darker one. And also in that set are a couple of little characters. So we could always decide to just stamp faces if you're a bit unsure about making a mess on the other strips of tape. We can always mask it off. So we'll put a piece of card over there. Ink up just the face part. Mask that off there as well. And stamp the little face in the middle. So again, works really well with a larger stamp, just using a partial print off that. You don't have to use black ink, obviously. If you've got a dark colour, black's probably the only one that's going to show up. If you're using paler colours, there's a whole range of archival inks that you could use. And I'm going to make up a quick couple of projects using these just to show you them in place. So I'm going to clean this mess up again and then we'll come back. Right, so I'm back again with a few projects that I've started really using these bits of tape that we've made. First of all, I've used them to embellish some backgrounds for ATCs. These obviously they can have some more things put on, but they look really good. It's a jelly printed background. That's some mica sprays and some inks in the background. But they're quite good for that. And also I've decorated a couple of envelopes for Happy Mail. Just adding strips of tape, cutting the tape down to a narrower width. But again, it's just a little bit of embellishment. You can use them in your journals, on some cards. Use them for whatever you want, really. Just a few ideas. So I hope that you've enjoyed this. I'm sure we've all got some masking tape lying around at home. You might actually have some washi tape, some plain washi tape that you don't particularly like. You want to jazz it up a little bit. You can use that too. You can also use surgical micropore tape if you've got some of that. I think I might actually have a box here. So yeah, this sort of thing. Again, it's a papery tape and you can use that. But most people have got masking tape in their craft stash or their decorating stash. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed that and are inspired to have a go yourself. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you're not already subscribed. Talking of subscribers, I'm thrilled to have passed 500. Thanks to everybody who does sit and watch some of these videos that I make. I'm glad you enjoy it. I'm hoping to do many more next year. It's been a bit of a rush at the end of this year and I'm sure you can understand we're all busy with other things. So have a great Christmas if you're celebrating Christmas. Happy holidays, and I shall be back in the new year with more inspiration for you. Thank you very much. Bye.